Hi, how are you doing? I am Brandaline Johnson, in case you don't know me, and I want to talk about how you are gifted and how it's absolutely normal to have a psychic or mediumship experience and why. First of all, the very first thing is I like to share that you are a soul. You have a body, but you are a soul. So it's completely normal for you to have soul-based experiences. Some of the experiences that we have that are actually psychic experiences could be things such as deja vu, having deja vu, or hearing your name being called in a store and then nobody's there. That's a perfect example of having a psychic experience. Feeling like someone is watching you, or feeling the bed, somebody sit down in bed with you, or feeling like your animal's in bed with you and nobody's there. Those are perfect examples of having that psychic type of experience. Or have you ever given your friend really amazing advice and later on thought to yourself, where did that come from? Or how about goosebumps if you go to a certain place? Or what about feeling uncomfortable in certain places? Those are all your psychic senses. You're seeing, you're hearing, you're feeling, and you're knowing, and your mediumship. How about have you ever had a dream of your loved one after they passed away and the next day felt like you've really, really had a conversation with them? That is actually truly happening. So let me explain some simple ways that I could share with you that you will understand how you are receiving information on a psychic or mediumship level. Just like the examples I just gave you, but for the purpose of this video, let's go ahead and like all close our eyes right now. And I want you to imagine a whole bunch of balloons in all different colors. Can you see those balloons? And can you see the colors? Some of you may not be able to see the color. Or how about can you close your eyes and imagine the McDonald's archway? Imagine the McDonald's archway. Can you see the McDonald's sign? And whose eyes are you seeing those with? You're not seeing them with these eyes. You're seeing it with your third eye, your imagination. And so let's go on to hearing. Can you imagine in your head your mother's voice or your father's voice? Or an authority figure's voice. Can you hear the tone of their voice even in your head? That would be an example of psychic hearing because you are hearing this without these ears, not outside of your head. You're hearing it in your head. That would be an example of psychic hearing. So you can imagine, say, even your boss yelling at you or something like that. That's a perfect example. And why I keep saying imagine, imagine, imagine is because your imagination is your gateway. Your imagination is your third eye, your connection to all that is, to consciousness. So I think, and I was just talking to one of my previous students today on the phone, and she was saying that too, that she keeps telling everybody about the class because she is an amazing, gifted person after she's taken my class. I can't believe some of the stuff that comes out of her mouth. And I said, boy, you just really were on point with the exercise that I gave you. And she's like, yeah, it's literally whatever I'm imagining. I just need to say it out loud because my imagination is not really my imagination. It's actually information you're receiving from spirit, from somebody's spirit guide, or from consciousness. Because when we have that intention that we want to know something, right? That's another perfect example. Is if you ever told yourself, I really want to learn more about blah, blah, blah. Maybe it's like Reiki, hands-on healing, or I want to learn more about meditation. And later on that day, there's an article on your Facebook, and you didn't even type this anywhere. You just thought this, or you wrote it in your journal. That is synchronicity, my friend. That is your power as a soul to put it out there, put it out the word, right? Which is a vibration to go out there, and then the universe, your spirit guides, your angels, your past loved ones, and the universe and all of consciousness went out to bring you that experience. So it's not a coincidence, right? Not a coincidence. And that's another example. Coincidences, there's no such thing. It's all synchronicity. So it's completely normal for you to experience it. You're ex all of you guys that are watching this live, or those of you that are coming back and watching the replay, you've got to be going, oh my gosh, she's right. This really does make sense. And so, what about that feeling? What about psychic feeling, that gut feeling? where you just know something's going to be wrong, or you just know that person over there is somebody you definitely don't want to do business with. You just have this gut feeling. Well, that feeling is your psychic feeling. That gut feeling is your intuition. Everybody knows what gut feeling is, right? So that psychic, that seeing, hearing, feeling, and that knowing. Have you ever experienced just knowing something and you have no idea how you know it, where it came from, but you know it to the pit of your soul that you would actually argue to the death over what you know? That's also known as claircognizance, psychic knowing. So all of these things are normal, right? Now I'm explaining to you that all of these things are normal. So why wouldn't we go ahead and develop these invisible muscles so that we can tap into all that is in all areas of our life, in our health, to be able to be guided down the right path to go where we're really supposed to go? Because let me tell you, my friends, we are not here to pay bills till we die. We definitely have a purpose. There is something that you are here for, something big and special, and it's inside you and it wants to come out. But in order for it to come out, you need to go back inside yourself and develop these invisible gifts. And so that's what I'm inviting you to today. I wanted to give you some examples of it's normal for you to have these experiences, but I also have a really big message from Spirit that it's your job to connect to your inner muscles. It's your job to go back within and find out why you're really here. Not going through the motions, the daily motions of going to work and the daily motions of paying your bills and ignoring the fact that you're here for something way bigger and way more special. And I love teaching this class because I get to witness you guys discover what that is. And that's way bigger than any paycheck I'll ever get, is seeing you guys, your transformation. So I want to invite you to this. It's coming up October 3rd. It only have a few spots left. So as soon as it's full, I'm closing enrollment, but I want to invite you, my special soul friend, because we are one. We are one and we are souls. And it's meant for us to connect with our soul and to develop its muscles so that our human experience could be the best one ever, right? All right, awesome. So the link to the class is at the top of this video. And I also want to invite you, there's a link to a free webinar that I'm giving on how to meet your spirit guides. Because to me, that's the first step, is putting your team in place and understanding how they're guiding you and what they're telling you, and have a communication set up with them and a relationship set up with them so that you could get to where you're going on a smoother, quicker road. All right? So join me on that. And if you can't make the live webinar, still sign up because you'll get the replay for 24 hours after. All right. Awesome. See you later, soul friends.